Hello my dear students, welcome to my channel Python Ki Bhasha. In my previous videos, we have discussed about how to create the database, how to create the tables, how to insert the records in that tables, how to delete and update the records. Today, we will learn about functions used to fetch data from result set. If you are new to my channel or those who have not subscribed, please subscribe, and those who want to see my all videos, the links are given in the description box. If you like my video, please press the like button and share. For further notifications, please press the bell icons. So now let's start the class. Whenever you used to retrieve records from the database using the select command, we need to follow the functions. The functions are fetch all, fetch many, fetch one, and row count. That row count is not a function, it is a property of cursor object. We will discuss one by one. The fetch all functions, it fetches all records from the database and it returns a list of tuples. Fetch one functions, it retrieves the first record of the database. If no more rows are available, it returns none. Fetch many and the n parameters. This method fetches the next set of rows of queries and return a list of tuples. The number of rows returned can be specified using the n arguments, which default to 1. The row count function, it is not a property, it is a cursor object. It returns how many records you fetch. So we will discuss one by one. Now you see the first function, that is a fetch all functions. I am written these programs in a Python IDL. You see, the first is what? Import mysql.connector as SQL, we are discussing in the last videos. Then you are connecting that Python to MySQL, that is SQL.connector, host name is localhost, username is root, my password is 1234, and database I am using that EMP2. So if that connection is established or not, you can check that if db.isConnected functions, that successfully connected or unsuccessfully connected. If that database is not connected or any errors are there or any error is raises, that means that connection is not established. Then the third step is what? To create a cursor object. Now I am taking a variable or object, that is a cursor is equal to db.cursor functions. Now to execute the queries. So today's class we are discussing, suppose you are fetching the number of records from the database, how to fetch that records using the select command. I am passing that query select star from EMP data. My EMP2 database, I am creating a EMP data, is a table. Now I am show all the records from that tables. So suppose I am writing data is equal to cursor object, cursor dot fetch call, fetch all functions. That means all the records are fetched. Whatever records are available in EMP data, that all the records are displayed in the Python IDLs. So suppose you have a 4-5 records, that means you have to use that loops. I am using that for row in data, print row, I'm using that how many records you are displaying, that row count function. It is not a function, it is a property of cursor object. So I am writing count is equal to cur dot row count. That row count, it counts how many records you are fetching from the databases. So now you compile these programs, you see what is that outputs. You see that successfully connected, the database is connected and the records are in that EMP data. You have a four records, that four records are displayed, record 1, record 2, record 3, record 4, and the number of rows, the row count is counted, the four records are fetching from MySQL EMP databases. Suppose you see, suppose I am not using this for loop, suppose I am putting this message, putting that comments, I am not using this for loop. You see, just directly I am printing the data. That save it. You see that the database is successfully connected, but the records are in the list of tuples. The row count is counted, that is a four records, but the records are in the list of tuples because the rows are fetched in a list. Because you see in the bracket, one is a EMP number, Saurabh is a name, 30,000 is salary, and the mobile number. Inside that list, you have a tuples. You have a tuples. The all the first record, then second record, then third records, then fourth records, then likewise the records are fetched in the list of tuples. Suppose you are using that for loop and you printed, that records are printing line by lines. You see what is the difference between that. Suppose you are using that data, whenever you fetch all functions, you directly print the data, the data are in the list of tuple forms. So for using that, using the loop for row is equal to data, by I is equal to data, something else, that you are printing the data in a tabular forms. So yeah, in this program we are discussing how the data are how that all the data are fetched from MySQL tables, and the row count function is count how many records are fetched. The next function is what? Fetch one functions. You see, I am passing that parameters, passing the command select star from EMP data. Cursor object dot fetch one functions. It fetches only one records. And count how many records it is fetches. You run this program. So only one record is displayed and counted, only one record. So fetch one function fetches at a time only one record. Suppose you call these functions. Suppose you copy these functions. You run it. Another record it will fetch. You see the second record it will fetch. So anytime you can call that fetch one functions, one record it fetches from the databases. Now another way you can pass that query also, that suppose I am taking one variable, query is equal to suppose you pass this query, whatever that you are passing in execute functions, pass on variable, and that variable you can also pass. Query, you run this. And fetches, you are calling two times, it fetches two records. The next function is what? Fetch many functions. I have written that fetch many functions. Open that program, fetch many functions. I have already written that program, fetch many. You see, I have written the fetch many functions, that I am passing that same query select star from emp data. You can pass that conditions also. Suppose where emp salary greater than suppose 30,000. Now that fetch many functions, what suppose you are not mentioning any parameters, it fetches only one records. You see, run this program. You see, only one record is fetching. Clear? Now suppose you give the parameter, suppose I am putting this 2. You run this. You see what is the changes. Now two records, the first record already fetches, the first compilations you are displaying that one record, the next record is what? Two record, the two, the next record onwards it display the two records, 2 and 3, that the total number of records rows are fetched from the databases, that is a 2 and 3. So in this way, you can fetches from the SQL databases. Now you see, my database is EMP2, use EMP2, change, you see that select star from EMP, the records are available or not, you see. Sorry, that database is EMP data. No? EMP data. Table name is EMP data. No? See that the records are available. Clear? I am writing another program. Fetch. Fetch mix functions, that you see in this program I am calling one functions, again I am calling fetch one functions. So it fetches the first record and it fetches the second record. Now I am calling that fetch many of two functions, that means first it fetches the first record, then fetches second record, then the fetch many functions two means the third and fourth record it will displace. Run this program. See that the first fetch one function fetches one record, the number of rows is one, and the again I am fetch one function is calling. The second record is fetching, the records are two. Again, I am using that fetch many functions, that I am passing that parameter is two. that third onwards, the records are displayed, two records are displayed, third and fourth records, and the last, the row count function counted that you are displaying or you are fetching the fourth four records. So you see in this video that how that select query commands fetches one record, many records, and all the records from the databases. Thank you. Have a nice day.